what a nice crowd. We had a short delay, and I'm not sure if it's going to work all right. We're going to start anyway. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to what I believe is going to be a great concert. We have four groups of Valley residents and Winter Texans here tonight to entertain you on the same program. My name is Bill Lasky, and I'm going to be your announcer for this part of the program. Our first performers for this evening are the Senior Ambassadors. This group started over 26 years ago with just a few men who like to sing together, and as you can see when I open this curtain, it's expanded to over 30. Based now in Benson Grove Park in Mission, they come from 11 states and Canada and include men from 21 parks in the valley. Their ages now range from the mid-60s to the 80s somewhere, with an average age of 74 years young. This winter, they will have performed in 13 concerts throughout the valley. Practices, for those of you that might wish to join, are at Benson Grove on Fridays from 1 to 3. And if you open the curtain, please welcome to the stage the Senior Ambassadors. The director for the Senior Ambassadors is Mr. Gary Schmidtke, and the accompanists are Esther Hewitt and Rosetta Jeffrey. Will those of you who are able please rise and join the Senior Ambassadors in the singing of the National Anthem of the United States, followed by the National Anthem of Canada.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the
this next number by the Senior Ambassadors was a number arranged by Mr. Joe Lillies in 1928, and I believe I pronounced his name correctly. The Ambassadors call it their Valley Anthem. Enjoy real Valley home. favorite things, and Do Re Mi. The words and music, of course, were by Richard Rodgers and Oscar Hammerstein II. All are from The Sound of Music.
The sound.
The senior ambassadors will close this portion of tonight's program with a song I particularly enjoy. This one is arranged by Pete Schmuck. I believe that's what he pronounces that one also. It was written by Lee Greenwald. I know that you will enjoy God Bless the USA. Thank you, senior ambassadors. What a great way to start this program. Okay, now filing on to this, one of the most difficult things about this position is that we have three great groups for this first part of the program. Finding enough time between each one to sit them down and start the next one. And now filing on the stage are the lovely ladies from Magic Valley Chorus. These ladies are from the beautiful Rio Grande Valley and represent the national organization known as the Sweet Adalines. They are counted among 30,000 women. Adalines are committed to advocating the musical art form barbershop harmony through education and performance. Truly an international nonprofit organization, they are dedicated to the education and performance of folk group a cappella singing known as barbershop. For your information, once a year there are competition among some 35 sweet Adeline regions for going to their international, as it is called. In 2 years, this international will be held in Houston, Texas. Magic Valley Chorus is in its 18th year and thrilled to be here to entertain you. Under the direction of Marlis Gagnon, they meet to practice every Monday night at 7 p.m. at the Our Savior's Lutheran Church at the corner of 12th Street and Fern Avenue here in McAllen. Step the road, please. They always invite more ladies to join them. Ready for some good old-fashioned barbershop music? I take pleasure in to introduce their announcer. Their announcer for this evening's performance, Miss Janet Doyle and the Magic Valley Chorus.
Ragtime. I love the Jabba Jive and it loves me. thank you so much. You know, in 1945, Dave Barber and Peggy Lee wrote a song that has sentiments that's still true today. Even in our instant communication society we live in, all the text messaging and the call forwarding and everything we have, you still really don't know anything about the person next door. So we're going to sing a little song called I Don't Know Enough About You.
Routine. Oh, how I love them softly.
much. You've been a wonderful audience. We have one more song for you. And we try to end most of our performances with some kind of patriotic song because we do honor all of our veterans of this war and past wars, and we'd like to go all the way back to the Civil War and do Battle Hymn of the Republic.
Sneaking off the stage, they're going to be replaced by another favorite group from the Valley, the Men of Accord, with more barbershop harmony. Now, barbershop harmony is a unique American art form, dating back to those tonsorial parlors, minstrel shows of the 1800s. The Barbershop Harmony Society, as it is now known, was founded in 1938 when two men from Tulsa, Oklahoma, a Mr. Owen Cash and a Mr. Rupert Hall, were stranded in New York, in Kansas City, by, of all things, a snowstorm. Now, they started some harmony singing at a local hotel. They tipped the bellboy to find a tenor. This resulted in their starting a song fest in Tulsa early in 1938 with attendance of 26 men. Their numbers swelled rapidly, and by the third meeting, with over 150 attending, they raised such a ruckus that they stopped traffic on the street below. Now, the membership grew throughout the U.S. and became international in 1944 with a new chapter in Windsor, Ontario, Canada. It now has over 800 chapters with a membership of over 30,000. The Men of Accord of our valley were organized in 1992 with seven or eight men, and I don't know where their records came with that other lost soul. Membership today is over 60. They rehearse at St. Mark's Methodist Church on Tuesdays. They are known for their bow ties and their red vests, and they perform an average of more than 10 concerts a year. They love to sing, and it shows. Under the direction of Mr. Don Lewis and Mr. Bob Lemkules, I am pleased to present the Men of Accord, and here is their announcer, Mr. Doug Morton. Doug?
We take you back in time to early 1945. The end of the war is near, but no one yet realizes how it will end or how soon it will end. For now, American young men are serving their country in isolated stations all around the world. One of these locations is an island in the South Pacific. The island is under American control and is relatively peaceful. The personnel are well fed and have lots of free time. The weather is absolutely terrific, and they have been furnished with many items to help them pass the time. You would think that all of them would be cheerful and happy, but there seems to be a problem.
And I'm going to kick your butt. Well, it's okay this time. We'll let it go.
All right, who stole my Zippo?
Thank you.
The men in this unit, like most service units all over the USA, come from little towns and places no one has ever heard of. They talk about family, the girlfriend, small town activities. There'd always be a church picnic if it didn't rain. Remember, the preacher would announce the picnic and he would always add, "If the Lord be willing."
If the Lord be willing. And the creek don't rise. If the Lord be willing and the creek don't rise, we will all be together once again. With a howdy and a handshake, we will start congregating. I can't hardly wait until then. And when the good time's over and we all go home, we will know as we're saying our goodbyes that we'll gather back together if the Lord be willing and the creek don't rise. There'll be beans and burgers and games of root beer and songs of good cheer in the air. If the Lord be willing and the sky stay clear, everyone here will be there. And when the good time's over and we all go home, we will know as we're saying our goodbyes that we'll gather back together if the Lord be willing and the creek don't rise. There'll be beans and burgers and cakes of root beer and songs of good cheer in the air. If the Lord be willing and the sky stay clear, everyone here will be there. And when the good time's over and we all go home, we will know as we're saying our goodbyes. If the Lord be willing, we'll gather back together. If the Lord be willing and the creek don't.
Attention, attention all personnel. We have just received word that Iwo Jima has finally been taken. Yay! The casualty rate was very high. There will be an outdoor memorial service led by Chaplain Murphy. We are here to honor these brave men who have given their lives for their country. They shall be missed. And loved ones at home will mourn their loss. Let us celebrate their lives and that joyful day when we shall all be reunited. The men are looking forward to the scheduled USO show. The Andrews sisters are sure to sing their top hit. The men really like this song, and they have their own version of Beer Barrel Polka.
There's a garden, what a garden, only happy faces bloom there, and there's never any room there for a worry or a gloom there. Oh, there's music and there's dancing and a lot of sweet romancing, but when they play the polka, they all get in the swing every time they hear that oom-pa-pa.
Some of us remember what the war was like. Gas and tire rationing, food stamps, victory gardens. Yet we were all in it together. We did not even think of giving up. We're Americans. Irving Berlin, a Russian immigrant Jew, wrote a patriotic song during the First World War, but he put it away, thinking it too sentimental and emotional. Many years later, Kate Smith was looking for a song to help sell war bonds, and she asked Mr. Berlin what he might have. He dug out this song, you all know it, and we ask that you would stand and join with us at the final chorus. Our director will bring you in as we sing, God Bless America.
While the storm clouds
with us.
God bless America.
Men of Accord, ladies and gentlemen, with a little help. Wasn't that a great first half? You can take about 10 to 15 minutes. We're going to be open the curtain so we can set up for the next part of the program. It's time to go out and find those little necessary rooms out to the right.
Thank you.
Grand Valley Concert Band, under the direction of Don Voss. This group was organized 10 years ago with musicians who are Valley residents as well as Winter Texans from 17 states, 3 provinces, and of Canada. These men had a dream of presenting big band concert music throughout the various parts of the Valley. This year, over 70 members strong, they have performed 7 park concert locations prior to tonight. For your enjoyment, their first song this evening is a fanfare for woods and percussion, depicting the rise of the phoenix, a mythological creature that is consumed by fire, only to rise again. By Steve Reinecke, it is entitled Rise of the Firebird.
Thank you.
includes Mr. Williams' movie themes, Superman March, Cadillac of the Skies, and the main theme of Star Wars. Here is your Rio Grande Valley Concert Band and Soaring with John Williams.
Thank you.
about this last number. Featured here with the piccolo solo is M. Lasky. Enjoy our national march, John Philip Sousa's Stars and Stripes Forever. Church, which is over here on Fern and 12th. You go up 10th Street, turn off at Fern, two blocks to the left. It's a patriotic concert, and it's going to be at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. End of commercial. I wanted to tell something else. How was that? What day? Oh, you got to know that too, huh? Holy cow, this is going to be on the 16th, which is what, a week from Sunday? A week from Sunday. I'm sorry, I've been doing this so long, I forget little minor things like that. And I'll probably hear about it later tonight, I think. As with all performances, as all the performers are gathering, and I see they've gathered again on stage, there is a little bit of time I'm going to take to give my thanks and those of all of these folks to all of the people to see that all goes well, to see that this is possible. The person most responsible to see that all this goes well this year is Mary Seward. Mary is the president of the Magic Valley Chorus. She coordinated things associated with the Civic Center, including, as I understand it, the work with the stage crew, the sound technicians, the lights, and so forth. And our thanks go to them also, as it could not happen without them. Then each group represented practiced very hard for all winter for the numbers that you just heard. I announced their directors before, and they deserve one more big round of applause. Now, I can't forget the ticket sellers, the ticket takers, or those that collected your money somewhere in the valley here, because, again, it couldn't be done without them. And without the cooperation of all, including some I very inadvertently probably forgot, nothing would happen. Now it looks like we're ready to go, so on with the show. The last number this evening is a medley of patriotic songs performed by all on the stage. This production was arranged by my fellow North Dakotan, Mr. Jim Clark. We think that you will enjoy a patriotic medley.